dating violence affects millions of teenagers around the United States. Teen dating violence can be similar to domestic violence. There are three major areas that teenagers get abused in violent relationships: physical abuse, verbal abuse and emotional, and just recently added, cyberbullying. Now, as a parent or a guardian, it's important for you to know the signs to look out for if your teenager is in a negative relationship. One of the signs include becoming reclusive. When a teenager begins to withdraw from regular activities that they would normally love to participate in, that is a sign that there is something wrong. Another sign of teen dating violence is dropping grades. When a teenager's grades begin to drop in the school, a child that usually would perform at a high level begins to slip in their grades, and they absolutely have no concern about making it better, then there is definitely something wrong. Another sign of teen dating violence is when a teenager becomes overly dependent on affirmations. They always want you to affirm whether they look good, whether they're doing the right thing, and it becomes excessive. Affirmations are good, as we all need that. But when it becomes excessive, that is a sign that somebody somewhere is saying something negative to bring that person down. So as a parent or guardian, when you notice some of these traits and signs, please be very attentive. Ask as many questions as you possibly can and keep a close watch on your teenager. Now, in order to prevent some of these negative situations, it's very important for us as parents and guardians to equip our teenagers with tools that allows them to not only identify but avoid negative relationships. One of those tools is letting them understand what it takes to develop healthy boundaries around their relationships. Healthy boundaries include having the strength to say no when you want to say no, and understanding that it's okay. That is one of the ways that teenagers and families can prevent negative dating situations. Another preventive measure is ensuring that your teenagers go out in groups. If they're in relationships or friendships, it's healthier when teenagers are clustered together in a group. Like they say, there is safety in numbers. Another third precaution that I would highly recommend is knowing where your teenager is at all times. They are not responsible for themselves. As a parent and as a guardian, we are fully responsible for our teenagers. So whenever your teenager is not within your care or within your personal location, it's important for you to be aware and to know where they are. So teenagers, make sure you have somebody in your life who can always be accountable to you and you can be accountable to. In ensuring all these ways, we help prevent and safeguard our teenagers from getting involved in negative relationships.
Hello, my name is Anya Namosai, and I am a Global Youth Ambassador with the Honeydrops Foundation. As a teenage girl, I value healthy boundaries around my relationships. I am the solution.
Hello, my name is Damilara Adu. I am a Global Youth Ambassador partnered with the Honeydrops Foundation. As a teenage boy, I understand that no means no. I am the solution.
The Honeydrops Foundation is a 501c3 nonprofit in the city of Dallas, Texas. We are partners with the DeSoto Public Library Teen Services Department by hosting seminars and workshops at their Teen Expo. If you'd like to get in touch with us to bring us into your organization or your schools to offer those same services, reach us on our website, honeydropsfoundation.org, or send us an email, info@honeydropsfoundation.org, and connect with us on social media, on Instagram and Facebook, @honeydropsfoundation.
We are the solution.